these infrastructures go away to the private sector, and they will go somewhere. Digital economy like industrialization is going to come. The routes can be changed, but the force and its efficiencies are so high that people want it. It's not I or you, but people want it. So the question is, what kind of roles we need to save for the governments in this new institutional ecology? Like in the case of industrial economy, these cannot be ad hoc. And that's the problem with our government, that these systems have always been ad hoc. They have to be rule-based, and we actually think many of these new institutions have to be constitutional institutions. We need more constitutional institutions which are managing some kinds of our collective data, and we call data constitutionalism. We do need public roles, because if public infrastructure and governance roles are not taken up in a digital economy, then the private sector would do it. Some global centers in the US and China will control the whole world. And when we engage with digital economy, we also have to answer these questions. And I'm therefore not saying that every activist who is fighting for MGNREGA on Aadhaar issues has to simultaneously also talk about it. I completely understand. The immediate fights are important, and when you are focused on that, you are focused on that. But I am putting my perspective that some of us, when we frame digital economy discussions, we need to talk about where is it all going and what are the kind of public roles we should save, which governmental interventions we should oppose. I'm talking as government, as an entity, democratic government, as an institution which we earned over many centuries, and what kind of public sector roles should we save for it.